say I appreciate everybody for coming out and showing us some love on today. I enjoy myself. I never thought I would be married, but today I am married.
Amen. Praise the Lord. But I truly thank God for being here on today, and I truly thank God for everybody that came out on today. I truly thank God for what He is doing for me right now in my life. Amen. I want to tell my wife that I love her dearly. Amen. I did pursue her for a whole year. Amen. Every time I called on the phone, I would ask her, okay, will you go out with me? Will you do something with me? Will you? No, 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 no. I heard no for a whole year. And I said, well, by December, I was almost ready to leave. But something told me to stay, and that was God. And look at where we are now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Gathered here this afternoon to worship God and to witness the marriage of Jaquavian Lazelle Hawkins and Keisha Jashel Huff. Bible says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Shall we pray? Most gracious and living God, for grace we have come this afternoon. May this ceremony be pleasing in your sight and bring to us your everlasting blessing. Amen. Dearly beloved, we're gathered together in the sight of God to join together this man and woman in holy matrimony. It is an honorable estate, instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and his church. That holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle in Cana of Galilee. It is commended in the scriptures to be honorable among all. Therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and soberly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons present come now to be joined. Who will give this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Gives me care, weathering the storm.
ever in these
guns. Jaquavian Lazelle Hawkins, will you take Keisha Jashelle Huff to be your wedded wife? Live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony. Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all of this, keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live. If so, say I will.
I will.
Keisha Jashelle Huff, will you take Jaquavian Lazelle Hawkins to be your wedded husband? To live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health? Forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live. If so, say I will. Bible says, put on therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, vows of mercy, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another and forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. Above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye are called in one body. And be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Jaquavian, would you take him by the right hand? I, Jaquavian.
I, Jaquavian.
Take thee, Keisha.
Take thee, Keisha.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have.
To have.
And to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
And for not so richer.
And for not so
in sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
Till death,
death
us do part.
Us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
Do I give thee.
Do I give thee.
My pledge.
My pledge.
Acacia, would you repeat in kind? Acacia.
Acacia.
Take thee, Jaquavian.
Take thee, Jaquavian.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For not so richer.
For not so richer.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
To love.
To love.
And to cherish.
Cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
Do I give thee.
Do I give thee.
My pledge.
My pledge.
As a token of this covenant, you will now give and receive the marriage rings, the unbroken circle, the emblem of eternity, the emblem of that which is least tarnished and most enduring, or to show how lasting is the pledge you have made each to the other. Let us pray. Father, bless, O Lord, these rings, that as Jaquavian and Keisha wear them, they may abide in your peace and continue in your favor until their life's end. Through Jesus. Place it on the finger. Repeat after me. With this ring.
With this spring.
I thee wed. In the name of the Father. And of the Son. And of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Take that ring and put that on his finger.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the
Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
All things I've done before this, they only think. And all the words spoken before this won't be said again. Suddenly so much of me has no need to pretend. There's nothing like the truth to bring her back to you. And everyone I've met before this ain't seen me with you.
Declares that those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Jaquavian and Keisha have consented together in holy wedlock, have witnessed the same before God and this congregation, and in so doing have given and pledged their vows to each other, have declared the same by the giving and the receiving of rings, now pronounce them man and wife together. Name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
We need to pray things. Bow your heads, please. Oh God, thou who hast consecrated the state of marriage, that in it is represented the spiritual marriage and unity between Christ and his church, look mercifully upon these your cherished servants. May they love, honor, and cherish each other. So live together in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and a haven of peace. We pray this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jaquavian Lazelle Hawkins.
Yeah.
believe it's true. I'm standing here in front of you, and you are here with me. So unbelievable, I never ever let you go. My heart is yours for keeps.
Let's make a vow.
Let's make a vow, baby.
Right here and now.
You just may come in today, but that won't be a time where it's going to be a process before you really, really get to know each other. Down through this new journey that you all are just taking today, if you don't handle the process correctly, you'll cause a problem later on.
And in my clothing, as I take my seat, for 1 Corinthians says, love is as bearing all things.
Yeah.
So Jacqueline, you in case you are going to invention, the love that you have is going to bear all things.
Yeah.
That means it's going to cover all things.
Yeah.
Whatever comes your way, the love of God and the love you have on the inside for each other, ain't nothing going to be able to stop you as long as you keep that up.
Yeah.
And love is an action thing. That means it's going to take some work.
Yeah, yeah.
You love each other today. And to keep that strong love, see, the one thing about it that we forget to realize is the love that we have on the day that we got married is the love that we have to keep nourishing so it can stay that way.
Yes. Yes.
And so I encourage you, and the love that you have will stand every storm.
Yes.
And see, there's going to be some storms in life.
Yes.
There's going to be some ups and there's going to be some downs.
Yes.
But the strong love that you have for each other, you'll be able to weather that storm.
Yes.
Sometimes it might feel like it's going to take you out.
Yes.
Sometimes you might desire to go in another room. But that love going to say, baby, you're going in there, I'm going with you.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
My name is Delicia Huff. Okay. My name is Delicia Huff. I'm Keisha's cousin. She's older than me by 3 months. But people call me Niecy. On behalf of the bridal party, we just want to say congratulations to both you and Jack, and we hope you guys have a tremendous life together. And we went through some things with Keisha, Bridezilla type things, but we still love her anyways. Where are your shoes? Where are you guys? Where is this? Where is that? But it's all love and love with all. We enjoyed the whole ride, and we just wish you guys, you know, a blessed life.
If you know me, you know that me and Keisha have been friends, or if you know Keisha, I mean, I'm not the person to get married, but if you know Keisha for a very length of time, you know that we grew up together, like been joined at the hip, literally, like we don't do anything like separately. I just wanted to say, you know, I'm really happy for you, and I'm just gonna read because I say a lot. Let's see. I just want to say, you know, you've definitely been a ride or die, and vice versa. There are definitely some times that I was just like, Jesus, Lord, help me, because I don't know what I'm doing with you. But, you know, we've both been there for each other all the way. And like I said, I'm just so overwhelmingly overjoyed that you married the love of your life. And, you know, we both, you know, did it the same year. And I'm just like really happy for you. And Jock, and I know you're going to take care of her because, you know, we already had that conversation. And so, lastly, you know, I just want to say, you know, just keep God first at the head of your marriage, and, you know, make sure your marriage is your marriage and not everybody's marriage. So, yeah, just be encouraged, and y'all know I'm here if y'all need me. So that's all I have. To the bride and groom.
I want to say I'm happy for them, man. Like, ever since he met her, I knew they was probably going to be together forever. I remember when I first moved back down here from Atlanta, I came over to the house, and I guess they had a little argument or something, and Jock was moping around the house. He wouldn't eat, he wouldn't drink no water. I said, what's wrong? He said, man, I don't know what I'm going to do, Uncle Pa. I said, what's wrong? Keisha mad at me. I said, man, pick yourself up. But nah, they got it together, man. Like, I like us since day one, so they good. Congratulations. Y'all going to be together for a couple of them.
I just want to say, you know, typically I don't condone getting married at a real young age, because typically I'm like, you know, just live a little bit and just make sure. But when you see these two, when you see them together, you see the way they look at each other, you know they're meant for each other. So definitely my blessings. And Jock, you know, he's always been conservative in a lot of ways. And And like he was saying, he just throw some things out. I was talking to him the other day, and he was like, "Man, your daddy, you know, me and Terry were first cousins." I was like, "I wonder what to say about your daddy." He said, "I know, man, if I was strong, I'd drop him myself." So I'm still laughing. So I just want to wish them the best, and I know they'll be well. Just keep God first, and y'all be good.
God bless you all. I love you both, and so happy for you. Everything is so beautiful, and you know, life and death and life is in the power of the tongue. That's what the word says. So be careful what you say to one another, because once you say it, you can't take it back. And if you do that, everything will be all right.
How y'all doing? I'm Brandon. That's my mama right there. I'm Josh's cousin as well. All I gotta say is, first off, boy, today was a very, very, very stressful day, but it's done with, it's over, y'all married, you have to do stuff. But to all that, Jock has been probably one of the, like, he's been a big influence in my life, especially when it comes to, like, looking at a godly man. You know, even though he's only 2 years older than me, it's just watching the way he's been serving God and the way he's on fire for God. It's a beautiful thing to see, because you don't see that with many people our age nowadays. And, you know, I knew right off the bat, as soon as I saw Keisha come to the country, I'm like, John got a girl to the country? They getting married for sure.
That I'm long because y'all saw me pushing punch and everything else because my feet is burning, so I'm sitting down. My name is Kim. I'm Jock's cousin. That's my shouting buddy, as y'all know. But I just want to say I wish y'all all the best. I think y'all are adorable. Jock, you did it. You was a little nervous. You called me yesterday. I was so tickled at you. Kim, I don't put this tux on. I don't know what I did. He was stuttering. I said, "Jock, you're going to be all right, man. You're going to be all right." I said, "By this time," I think I scared him to death, y'all. I said, "Jock, by this time tomorrow, boy, you're going to be married." And he got quiet. But nevertheless, welcome to the family. You've always been a part of the family since day one. Like Brandon said, when you make it to the country, you're doing pretty good. God bless you guys.
Hey, man, I just want to say to Jock and Keisha, congratulations. I am so excited for Jock and Keisha. But anyway, I've looked at them from time to time and seeing them together. And really, I believe that they are truly sincere by God. I've talked to Jock from time to time. He's brought me to the country and we talked and, you know, we pray together, we sing together. But if any two people exemplifies Christ, that's all I've seen in these two people. And I say to the parents, to the relatives of these two people, you should let it be an example for you. I thought about Jock the other day, and I know how sincere he is with God and how much he loved the Lord. And I just thought, you know, I said, "Lord, I know when Jock gets married, he's probably going to say, I am free. Praise the Lord, I'm free. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. My soul is resting. Oh, it's just a blessing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free." Praise the Lord. I just want to congratulate my grandson. I am his grandmother. And my new granddaughter-in-law. They know I love them to death. We have such great times together, just laying around and talking and joking. And I just wanted to just tell them, you know, that God love you, I love you, and y'all just keep doing what y'all doing.
Yes.
Keep God first.
Yes.
Jock, he's been, you know, loving the Lord since he was like 3 years old. He used to get way back up in the closet and beat his tambourine and pray. He said, "I got to hide from my mama." Way in the midnight hour, you know.
And he's always been like that in church, you know. And then when he met Keisha, I found out that she was the same way, raised up in the church like that. And I just thank God for both of them, because I know God put them together. You know, it says a man that findeth his wife findeth a good thing. And so y'all just do what you do and put God first, and I guarantee you your marriage will be great.
The church for the amen.
Amen.
I'm Keisha's brother, if y'all know. I just wanted to say I love y'all. That's it.
I love you. Okay, hi everybody. I'm Keisha. Keisha's one of Keisha's bridesmaids. And I have some dedication. Now, I'm going to take them YouTube job. Okay, Keisha, girl, you've been getting on my nerves for 9 straight years. I'm going to tell y'all what Keisha did. When I was first pregnant with my first child, she used to call me, Keisha, Mike going to have a big head when she come out. I said, Keisha, no, she's not. She ain't going to have a big head. You're going to have a big head. Nah, for real, she's going to have a big head. I'll be touching your stomach, and I'll be feeling her head moving. I said, okay, Keisha, you feel her head moving. How come my baby actually came out with a big head? So, Keisha, I want to thank you for blessing my baby with a big head. But then also to Jock. Jock, you've been getting on my nerves too. I always have. Yeah, I still love you, and I just hope the best for you and Keisha both. Y'all know what I've been through. Y'all ain't gonna go through me. But, I just pray that God be with the both of you, and I love you. And after this, come get Caleb. Still getting on my nerves.
I thank the Lord that things were well with me. You know, I think about these children when they're coming down. They look like they enjoy coming, see? Because I always try to teach them the right thing. And I think about they started a little meeting at my house. And John Quills with the head, and I got another granddaughter who ain't here, her daughter. They started having church in my old house. Everything went so pleasantly. Everybody passing, going to the church house, and John Quill and them having church in the old house. So we all pray for him to hold on, because he's been on that road a long time.
Yes.
And if I ain't going to lead him, too, he might not lead him for a corner. Every time somebody tried to guide him, I'd tell him the right thing. So y'all pray for him.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, I just want to tell her that we here now. And you got to just go on about our business. Like Jane said, she said, I'm free.